Hello, welcome to another episode of the Thought Leadership Podcast and live show. You might be watching this on Facebook, you might be watching this on YouTube, or listening to the episodes on the various different podcast platforms. And in any way, I'm really excited to be here with you, and we are going to talk about a topic that I love, and I'm really excited to share this with you. So we're going to jump right into how you can create qualifying, lead nurturing, amazing content that will really generate lead, generate ideal clients, dream clients, people who want to be part of what you are creating, being, you know, part of your services, part of what you're creating. So this is for you who are a coach, consultant. You might be having like an online course or a group coaching or VIP coaching or a consultancy, and you are already creating content. But the content that you create, most of the time I have people coming to me say that, well, either you don't create content, you know, you're just like in the beginning of how do I even start. But this episode is more for you who are already creating content, and you might be creating content every week. You even have, you know, overcome the fear of creating live Facebook lives or LinkedIn lives. You are out there, you are producing amazing high quality content, you're thinking through what you're doing, you are, you know, taking the time, you maybe even create, you know, learn about how to edit or stuff like that. So you are in it, but somehow all the effort you're putting in, it doesn't pay off. Even if you're on Instagram stories, on Facebook, if you're all these things that you are creating, it doesn't pay off. And what I mean by paying off is basically in the end of this content creation, you still have your family and friends liking your posts, you know, saying, how you look beautiful in this photo. Or you have people kind of showing up and saying, I'm interested, but they are not the right qualified audience. So you end up with feeling kind of frustrating, saying, I put all this effort creating this content and I want to create more leads and I want to have more people in my programs and I want to serve more people, but the content creation I have is not getting people, you know, inside my world. So this is very, very common. And I want to talk about the three common mistakes that people do who are already content creators when it comes to create lead nurturing content. Because here's the thing, you might be creating really amazing content. I mean, I'm talking, you're putting the effort in, you're conscious about what you're sharing, but great content doesn't not necessarily equal lead nurturing content. And this is something that it's hard to understand sometimes, say, but if I create all this amazing content, then people will come. But there is more to it. And this is what this episode is about. It's about how do you go from creating content, you know, putting this effort in and actually putting less effort in, because you don't have to put so many hours to get, you know, the 20-80 of the content creation, and going away from those, you know, this all this time and this production that doesn't lead anywhere really, to create quality content that is going to constantly every week generate you leads that are going to show up in your, you know, qualified leads, dream clients wanting to work with you. That's what I want for you. So this is what we're going to talk about today. So why content, and why do I want to talk about organic content, is that most of you who are listening and watching this episode, you don't go with Facebook ads, or you maybe have tried doing paid advertisement, but it's not something that is, you know, generating a lot of results yet. And Facebook ads can be amazing, paid advertisement can be amazing, but the way that you will have people showing up to your calls or your webinars or your email list or even to your programs, your coaching programs, is through content. Most of the time when you're starting out, how do you get people to get to know you if they are not already in your network? Most of the time is through content. So if you don't have a clear content strategy, you might end up with an amazing program, amazing, you know, services that no one knows about. And this is what we want to change in this episode. We're going to start going into this topic, and this is something I spend a lot of time talking about in our stage 2 program, because I really truly think that if you have, you know, an amazing opportunity for people to join you and you don't have, you know, a funnel, like how do people actually find you, then the content strategy has to be on point, really super clear, really qualifying, you know, super valuable. So we want to talk about how you can upgrade your content to become that. And then, of course, that's going to be the base for ads. If you are thinking of, like, you know, I would love to learn how to do Facebook ads and or other type of ads, when you have amazing lead nurturing content, then you can boost that with ads as well. So you are warming up your accounts and you are warming up your audience and you are testing the messaging. So it's really even the base of creating amazing results with ads. So it's not something like, should I have ads or not? No, it's both. But when you want to have great return on investment, it's also about creating those amazing lead nurturing pieces first that you can then boost with ads if you would like to, but you don't even have to do that. Most of the things I've done is actually organically in the last 10 years and it has been working really well for us. So you can go far with good content without having to add ads to that. Okay, so no more talking about ads. I want to go right into the topic and I'm going to talk about three different parts that you can improve and you will see yourself which part is the most important for you to start with. But most of the time when you hear about them, you will realize that actually, wow, there is something I can do about it, I can tweak about right now, today. So let's talk about the first one. When it comes to your content, why people might not, you know, going further with you after you're producing that content piece, is that it might to be too general. So if you take a topic and you speak about it, you know, if you might even have a podcast or YouTube show, or let's say you're on Instagram, Facebook, no matter where you are, or no matter what type of content you create, either it is, you know, a video or you write something or you share some photo and something like that, no matter what that is, if it's too broad, too general, it will not speak to your audience. Because let's face it, there's more and more content creators out there and content creators spend a lot of time creating content. So high quality content gets attention. If you're doing something very broad and general, it will not stand out in the noise of all the content that is out there. So you want to create content that is not too broad. Not just, you know, like I can give you an example, like you cannot talking about productivity or remote work or leadership. It's such a broad topic. We want to go deeper and say, okay, how can I narrow it down to one core piece that is going to, you know, we will talk about this specific thing, this specific situation, this specific question, and I'm going to go to the point. And why? Because if you think about the listeners, your viewers, people who are watching, you know, your followers, they want to know what's in it for me. Because they are not following you just because, you know, they like what you're doing. They also want to learn from you. They also want to get value from you. So they are thinking when they're listening to you, they're watching an episode with you or watching like your videos, they want to understand, what can I get from this? What can I learn from this? What can I experience from this? And if you are never really getting to a point, let's say, about a topic, and they feel like, well, I kind of got inspired, they might feel good about it for a couple of seconds, but they will not remember that. However, if you create content that is going to like more like a niche within your bigger topic, it's going to be so much more valuable for them to watch that. So that's a way to go about it when you think about, you know, making it not too broad or too general. And this is really even good for you if you have podcast episodes, not just talking about like how to become more mindful in life. It's a very broad topic and you can write a book about it. So you want to be able to say, can I cover this topic in, let's say, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, or will I have to break it down into smaller pieces? That's a good way to think about it. Now, number two, let's say that you found a topic that is more narrow and niched, you have niched down to like one topic. So like, for instance, today I speak about content and I have six pillars I cover in my profit formula for coaches when it comes to, you know, increase their revenue. So when I talk about it, I could talk about the whole formula or I can go into the content piece. And that's what I'm doing today. I'm just going into this narrow, niched content piece section so you can go deeper into that. So that's the way you can think about your own content as well. Thinking, how can I narrow it down? Okay, number two, you are creating content. You have, you know, narrowed down to a smaller subcategory that you speak about. However, you might not giving enough value. And here's the thing, if you are, you know, having a coaching program or consulting an online course and that, you might be thinking, what part should I give away and what part should I actually give for free, or, you know, well, give away or keep for my clients. And here's the thing, you can basically give away everything, because when you talk about, you know, the things that you're doing in your programs, you are not giving away the information, you're giving away the step-by-step process, you're giving away the implementation of what you have, what you are creating. So for instance, in my stage two program, what people are paying for is to actually go from, you know, having a kind of a business, but not really coaching, consulting business, not really working so well, to have a stable income of 5 to 10K per month within 90 days. That's the framework. That's what we're working towards. That's, you know, that's the direction we are taking. So when you are creating, you know, I can talk about these topics. I can even give you some, you know, some concepts and some ideas, and in all these episodes that I'm doing for free, in my free value, you know, my free content. However, the actual process, how to put it together, the step that by the step process, that's what people are paying for. That's the actual, you know, coaching part. And coaching is, of course, having my feedback, asking me questions, getting feedback from the community. All that is part of the experience. So if you giving amazing content, and you're actually giving away, you know, real advice, real tips, real value, people will just want more of you, because they say, oh my God, if I got this part for free, I cannot even imagine what's on the other side. I can even not even imagine what do I get when I join the program. So here's the thing. For you who are creating great content, you say, and some of you tell me sometimes, you're like, but Daria, when people come to my programs, they love it, I get great testimonials, they get great results. But on the other side, people don't know about it. You know, outside your programs, the ones who aren't paying, they have no idea how amazing things you are doing. So give a bit of that in your content, start sharing and give away, because it's not about giving the whole framework, it's about giving one concept or one idea or answer one question, but going all in. Don't keep, you know, saying like, oh, if I give this away, no one will join my programs. It's the opposite. The more you will give, the more they want to join, because they see that, oh my God, this is the real thing. She really knows her stuff, or he really knows what he's talking about. So you want to be able to give real value in your content. Really don't limit yourself. When you have something that you can share and you see that you can help someone, answer that question or go through that concept. That's okay, because that's what people will then connect with, because they will feel, wow, she's really generous, or he is really generous in her free content. How will it be to be part of that program? That's the difference. That's what you want to go for. So give value, don't be afraid, because what people are paying for is implementation, not the information that you're sharing. They will even want to have even more support from you if you do that. Okay, number three, you might create amazing niched content. You are, you know, you're narrowing it down to one specific topic that you can cover in 30 minutes, 60 minutes. You are also creating value. You're giving away, you know, real information. You're not limiting it. You're not thinking, oh my God, they're not paying for this. Will they join my program if I would give all this? You're just there to serve. You are supporting your community to get one concept, one question, getting one breakthrough. Now, all that is amazing, but if you don't lead your content towards your actual services, you might end up with people liking what you do, coming to you, say, I loved it, but you don't know how to take them to the next step. So make sure, and this is very, very common, I see that very often, make sure that your content actually is generating leads for your group coaching, for your VIP coaching, for your online courses, whatever you're doing, for the service that you are, you know, people can pay for, the service that you are providing, the way you are actually working with people, the content is the first step of that. So all your content should be aligned with the content in your programs. So in my program, we have 6 pillars, and I have 2 different programs. My first program, my stage 2 program, my implementation program, I have 6 pillars. And in those 6 pillars, I talk about all the time in my podcast, in my content, in my, you know, everything I'm doing, because I want to have listeners who actually care about those topics. I want people to say, well, I want to have an amazing premium offer for my VIP clients. I want to create an amazing group coaching. I want to know how to sell and generate leads. I want to create quality content in 30 minutes per week and not more. I want all of that. That's what I want for my community, because I want to attract people who actually care about those topics. If I would speak about, you know, I've made 2 TEDx. If I would speak about TEDx and I would speak about how to get on the TEDx stage, or I would speak about, you know, other topics that I care about, like group dynamics, I really care about how to, you know, create masterminds, stuff like that. As at the moment, my programs that I have about it are in the back end, and you cannot buy them and you cannot access them, and I'm not selling them. They're only for our members. I'm not going to talk about those topics because those topics are too general, and they're not going to lead to someone actually being able to get the support they need with that. So this is how I want you to think as well. If you're talking about the topic, and this is also very common if you're invited as a speaker, if you're invited to, you know, to be on webinars, or you're invited to speak on the podcast, make sure that the topic you speak about is 100% aligned with what you actually provide in your group coaching, in your VIP coaching, in the pillars that you are, you know, serving your community with when they work with you. The more you will do that, the more you will attract qualified leads. So always having, you know, niche content that is 100% related to what you teach in your program. So that way you build a community, an email list, and all the people are coming to your, you know, to your free community actually care about those topics. This is very, very important if you want to be able to create lead nurturing content. And here's the thing, you're going to create more and more leads because you're going to speak to people who actually care about what you have to share, that are going to be interested in go further, some of them, to get more support from you. So those are the 3 things we spoke about, not to be too broad or too general. We spoke about creating, really giving value, 100% value, not, you know, thinking about should this be in the program or not. If you want to help someone, just answer those questions, help your community to break through those limiting beliefs or those steps that they need to know, because it's just one part of the whole picture. You're not giving away the implementation, you're just giving away some support. And make sure that it's always 100% related and aligned with your programs, with your paid services, that you have people showing up that care about the topics already before. You're already preparing them for the way you speak about those topics, so they can know if they can relate to that or not. It's going to be a game changer. And I would love to hear from you which one you think is the most valuable for you when you start. So please share in the comments below. Do you think it's your content can be less broad? Do you think that you can give more value in your content? Do you believe that you can relate it more to your programs, to have more alignment in those programs? Think about those things. And I don't want you to stop here. I want you to get the chance to actually create it right now, because my content, my podcasts, my YouTube videos, my live videos, all this, I want you to actually take action on that. So in the show notes, when you go below this video, you will find a worksheet that I created for you, a free worksheet that you can download and you can work through in 1 hour. And in that worksheet, you will have ideas and support to create 10 lead nurturing content pieces in under 1 hour. So if you feel like, oh, I'm still not sure how to do this, I'm really excited, I'm starting to see it, but you actually want to take action right now, and I know you want, because my community is full of action takers, download the worksheet, get to work, put 1 hour, and have 10 content pieces ready. Because if you have 10 content pieces ready right now, you will have, as we are recording this in September 2020, you will be able to have enough content for the rest of the year for each week of the year starting now. How amazing is that? So that's what you can do right now. And please share this episode if you think that someone needs to hear this. Tag people who need to hear it. Comment and always review our episode on all the different podcast episodes platforms, because the more you like and share and you let us know what's resonating with you, what you're learning, the more we can produce even better content for you, even more on point, and keep supporting you. So thank you for tuning in. I was really happy to be here with you today, and until next time, bye bye.